Hi, this is Kate from MinuteEarth. Most rain never reaches the ground because it falls on the oceans. But even a lot of rain that falls over land doesn't reach the ground. Some of it disappears before it gets very far. As raindrops fall, they pass through warmer and warmer air, which evaporates more and more water molecules from their surfaces. Measuring that water loss is tricky. We can't levitate rain gauges at different heights in the sky to directly measure how much rain evaporates. But computer simulations suggest that about 40% of falling rain disappears back into the sky. And when rain does touch down, it lands mostly on Earth's forests. That's because wherever lots of rain falls, thirsty trees dominate by growing tall and wide and shading out most other plants. Those big leafy canopies also happen to intercept almost all of the rain that falls on them. However, just as people can't drink through their skin, trees can't absorb water through their leaves or bark, so the intercepted water isn't directly of use to them. Most of it drips off or runs down their trunks, eventually reaching the ground, where the trees can suck it up with their roots. But some of the treetop water also evaporates off of the leaves and bark, returning about 15% of the rain that originally left the clouds back up into the sky. That alone might not sound like a lot. But when combined with the raindrops that evaporated on the way down, it means that more than half of the rain that falls over Earth's land never reaches the ground. That immense amount of water instead flows back upwards as vapor, the equivalent of 15 Amazon rivers climbing, invisibly, through the sky. Thanks to Georgia Southern University for sponsoring this video, which was made possible by a National Science Foundation grant to John Van Stam. Van Stam is a professor in GSU's Department of Geology and Geography, and he studies how well different trees capture rain that falls on them. Research from his group and its collaborators has helped us understand the vital importance of these rain-catching abilities, including the way they reduce stormwater flooding during heavy downpours, thus saving us billions of dollars a year in flooding damage. Thanks, Georgia Southern!